This is a land at the mercy of God. Blessed and cursed. This year, the spring and summer rains failed, leaving parched earth and scrawny cattle. Bertukan Ali's tears are for the son she buried a few days ago. His name was Abdu Muhammad. He was 5. His grave crowned with freshly picked vines. Malnutrition now stalks northern Ethiopia.
When he died, I felt I had lost everything. My family buried his body. Everyone is in hardship. We all have so little to eat because there was no harvest this season. Everyone is suffering.
The UN says in one area, 2 babies have been dying every day. Bertukan, one of many mothers, left inconsolable. At this well, things are getting desperate. People travel here from miles around to give their livestock a drink. But the water table has fallen to almost nothing. 30, maybe 40 meters down, it's full of silt and mud. The well almost dry. Help is arriving, too late for some, and in too small a quantity for the scale of the emergency. At this food distribution center, 2,000 people wait for rations that will last them a month. In all, more than 8 million people across an area roughly the size of the UK now need food aid. The drought has reduced yields from this year's harvest by as much as 90%. The village of Keugaria, population 5,000, sits in the heart of the drought zone. This substantial watering hole was a lifeline for livestock in the village. Now it is bone dry. In fact, the moisture content of the soil in this area is the lowest it's ever been. Many here remember the 1984 famine that spawned the global humanitarian response and the Band-Aid single. Abara Weldu, now in his late 60s, has lived here all his life.
Although this drought has just started, it's going to get worse. It's already really severe. Some people have died of hunger. Others are sick in their beds. Right now, it's just like 1984.
The government is in much better shape than 30 years ago to cope. Officials were in the village today, but more international help is needed.
We went from 4.5 to 8.5 million people needing food aid in just the last 2 months. We know it's going to get worse soon. We know that the needs next year are going to be far higher and far more entrenched. And despite our massive best efforts, including remarkable efforts by the government, this is not enough.
By early next year, local food reserves will run out, leaving as many as 15 million people relying on aid, more than need help in Syria. Bertukan has already paid a heavy price for the cruelty of Mother Nature. Who'll be next? Clive Myrie, BBC News, in northern Ethiopia.